हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल नो बायोलॉजी नो लाइफ एंड आई एम योर एडुकेटर शोम्पा शाहा। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट और द आउटर मोस्ट कंपोनेंट ऑफ अ लिविंग सेल, दैट इज सेल वॉल, एंड इट इज इन योर चैप्टर नंबर 5 ऑफ साइंस, द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। So we have to know at first that what is cell wall. Before knowing the definition, we have to remember that only the plant cells have cell wall. No animal cells have cell wall. Then the question arises, what is called cell wall? Cell wall is a structural layer surrounding some types of cells just outside the cell membrane. Mainly it is present in the plant cell. It can be tough. So what are the characteristics of a cell wall? It can be tough, flexible and sometimes rigid. It provides the cell with both structural support and protection and also acts as a filtering mechanism. So what is cell wall? A cell wall is the wall of a cell in plants, bacteria, fungi, algae and some archaebacteria. The cell wall is the tough, usually flexible but sometimes fairly rigid layer that surrounds some types of cells. It is outside the cell membrane and gives the cell support and protection as well as acting as a filter. Then the question arises, which kind of organisms have a cell wall? The main kinds of organisms that have cell walls are plants, fungi and certain prokaryotes and bacteria. In plants, cell walls are mainly comprised of complex polysaccharides. These polysaccharides are sugar-based polymers and these kinds of polysaccharides are cellulose, hemicellulose, etc. All the plant cells having a rigid cellulose outside the cell membrane, and that is called a cell wall. And the function of the cell wall is, the main function of the cell wall are to provide structure, support and protection for the cell. The cell wall in plants is composed mainly of cellulose and contains three layers in many plants. The three layers are the middle lamella, primary cell wall and the secondary cell wall. The cell wall is made up of polysaccharides called cellulose, hemicellulose, pectin, lignin, suberin, etc. And it shows some characteristics like plasmolysis and deplasmolysis. So we have to know about plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is a process in which cells
lose water
in a hypertonic solution. The reverse process, deplasmolysis or cryolysis, can occur in the cell is in a hypotonic solution, resulting in a lower external osmotic pressure and a net flow of water into the cell. Deplasmolysis is the entrance of water into a plasmolyzed plant cell, causing the cell membrane to return to the cell wall. The example of plasmolysis. Plasmolysis is the process where a cell contains shrink away from the cell wall when placed in a hypotonic solution. An example is, if red blood cells are placed in a strong salt solution, plasmolysis would occur. And the example of deplasmolysis occurs as a reverse of plasmolysis. If red blood cells are placed in a liquid or dilute medium or in simple water, deplasmolysis occurs and water enters from outside the RBC into inside, and the red blood corpuscles swells and thus lysis occurs. Next day we will discuss about nucleus. If you have any question, please ask me in my comment box. And guys, keep learning, happy learning, have a good day.